It's Sai once again with another video, and in this video I'm going to be telling you guys, well, give you guys advice for high school. First I'm going to do freshman advice and then just overall high school advice. But before that, I would like to thank you subscribers for subscribing, liking my pictures in my videos. Some of you guys, not a lot, but thank you for the ones who do like it, and thank you for the ones who comment on my videos, and just thank you, really, because it means a lot. It really does. So the big news that I told you in my previous video is that I'll be starting vlogs for you guys, if you want that. If you don't want it and you don't really care, then the news is not for you. But I've been talking to some family and they said I should do a couple things like vlogging and stuff, like give me ideas like that. And if you guys want to see my everyday life, it's going to be every day, but sometimes of my day, some parts of my day that you would like to see, then I'll show you it. So let's just get started in the video now. Wait, before we start it, pause the video right now. Pause it and like this video. Subscribe if you are not subscribed. Comment something, anything, really. Say hey, how you doing? Something like that. And now let's get into the video. So freshmen. So school starts, well, here in Michigan, it starts September 5th. Okay, guys, I'm kind of anxious for school, and then I'm not, because I like sleeping in. But the advice I want to give you guys is start trying to go to sleep early during now, at least 10 to 11:30. Just try to go to sleep early, so when the first school, like the last night of summer break comes, you won't be up all night because you're anxious about the first day of school. Because I was always like that, and I did not get any sleep. It was terrible. I was so tired of school, so sleep early. Remember to, have your alarm clock on. I usually have mine at 6 o'clock. I'm going to a different school, so, and it's closer, so I don't know if I have to wake up that early, but just have your alarm clock on, make sure it's ready, like pre-started. Like sometimes when I'm first doing a alarm, I will do it like, I will test it like 2 minutes later and I see if it's working or not, because there's days that it doesn't go off and I'd be looking crazy trying to hurry up and go to school. So test your alarm clock before you do it. Remember the testing alarm, remember to delete that, because what if it's during school and your alarm just goes off? Remember, you delete your testing. Sorry, something's happening on my phone. But so for freshmen, it's a new environment to be a freshman, because you're in middle school. Well, you were in middle school, and it was like you started to get the hand of being in an upper scale or upper skill type of thing. Like, first, it's elementary school, it's alright. You get older, and you're like in fifth grade, and you feel like the top dog because you're in fifth grade, the oldest grade in elementary school. And then you feel different once you go to middle school. Like, you're confused. Like, this is like, wow, what's going on? So this is how it is in high school too. I felt a little kiddish. Not too kiddish, because I wasn't like that. But it felt really, I don't know, grown, I guess. Because there's a lot of older kids. They look like grown men and grown women because they have lashes or their makeup did or whatever. Their hair did all long and stuff. And you're just sitting there, little, like, you're this little 14, 15 year old you're looking at all these people and they're so big and tall and stuff, and you're just this little girl or boy. It just seems really, I don't know, you feel really small, I guess. So that's how it is, basically. So let's talk about Freshman Friday, okay, guys? I remember Freshman Friday. Everyone kept on talking about it the first week, like, ooh, fresh meat. We're gonna get you guys Freshman Friday. And they were talking about it so much that our principal said if anyone tries to fight anyone, they get suspended or expelled, I think. But yeah. So they limited it, but I remember my experience with Freshman Friday. It was, Friday, and I was walking to my next class, and it was these group of boys. They're like 10th graders, and I was just in a circle of them, and they just kept on following me. I don't remember what they said, but they're just like circled around me, and I don't like people like that, especially if I don't know you. I don't like anyone just huddled up in my face. So it was like, oh my god, I didn't know what to say or do. I was like, excuse me, but yeah, they're gonna try to mess with you. But they didn't do it last year. I didn't, of course, because I think it's dumb, but yeah. What else? So they said that 9th grade is your most important year and 11th grade is your most important year. So I guess 9th grade is important because it's your first grade as a high schooler. And then 11th is important because of ACT and SATs. So, yeah. 10th grade, I had a grade, yeah. In freshman year, I started getting better grades, like all A's and B's. Because I usually get, in middle school, I only had A's and B's and one C, and I hated that. But I started getting A's and B's in my freshman year. And this year, I'm pretty sure I only had one B or two. Yeah. But I started getting good grades, so you need to be on your grades freshman year because they say it's the most important. And I believe it is because, I don't know, something about it. You need to have all A's and B's. Well, you want to succeed more, I guess? C's can cut it, I guess, but I don't like C's. I don't really like them at all. But, but to get good grades, you can study a lot. I'm not the studying type, I'm not gonna lie, but this is advice for you, but I didn't really study that much, but hey. But this is one test, it's one Spanish test. I studied it a lot, and I got a good grade. It was like a spelling test. And I didn't know how to spell anything in Spanish, so I really studied for that test, and I got an A+. So, studying works. You can study for that. And then what else? Let's talk about upperclassmen boys. They will try to talk to you like they know you or something. I used to look at them like, what? I don't even know you. But in 10th grade, I started getting more upperclassmen friends, and I don't know, I was cool with it, but in freshman year, I didn't want to hang with them. I was scared, honestly. Not scared, but like uncomfortable to make new friends. So I only had friends in my grade. Yeah. And sometimes freshmen, sometimes in high school, your friends will go to different schools or go to their different cliques or whatever, groups, friends. And it'll be different because in 8th grade I had some friends, but we put our ways, just like, I don't know, maybe summer did it, because over summer, did I have a phone? Did I have a phone over summer? I don't think I had a phone. Wait, I did have a phone, but it wasn't on. I started getting a phone right after my birthday, freshman year, like a major phone, but yeah, so I didn't stay in touch with my friends really, except one. And I really don't like being friends, like having a whole bunch of friends, cause like, okay. But yeah, that's me. Anyway, let's start with overall high school advice. What could I say? Well, I'm about to be in 11th grade, so let's see. What could I talk about? Sports, I guess. I'm not a sports person, but if you want to do sports, then work hard for what you believe in. Sure, in sports, you have to be a team player, and you might not always be friends with that person, but this is what I saw, okay? So, it was these group of girls. They weren't friends. Well, they were friends in middle school, then they parted their ways because drama. And then they had to be in volleyball, and they had, and they made up because of it. Now they're even closer, so yeah. Sports can help that. I think that's really cool that they just let that go, their problems. They're really good for you guys. I don't know if they're gonna watch this, but you know I'm talking about you, volleyball. But yeah, you're gonna make friends doing sports and stuff. You may come to school in a different state or city or something like that, and not have any friends, then sports come around, you can start making teammates, and they can actually be your friends. So, yeah, if you're a shy person going to a new school, just be, confident, you know? Just be like, hey, my name is this, I do this and that. Just be more, out there, I guess. Don't be just such an outsider. You can be yourself, but like, if you want to have friends, make yourself out there, make friends, be, mingle, I guess. I need to take this advice because I'm a shy person, and I'm going to a different school and a new city, so it's going to be hard for me to make friends, because I had this problem before, and it wasn't good. I only made one friend, but I switched to my other school, so. But, yeah, I think that's it for this freshman/high school advice. So please like this video, subscribe if you haven't already, comment what you would like to see on my channel, and comment if you would like to see vlogs. So bye, I love you guys, and have a great school year. Bye, I love you.